Ja, hallo Freunde. Ich bin jetzt mal wieder aus Damaskus und einige von euch werden ihn ja kennen hier neben mir. Wir sind hier heute bei Breaker. Ihr habt ihn ja schon gesehen, viele haben ja seine Videos geliked. Und ja, ich war beim letzten Mal im Januar schon hier bei Breaker, heute sind wir wieder hier. Und ja, wir wollen euch eigentlich heute mal erzählen, wie es hier bei uns heute in Damaskus oder jetzt die letzten Tage hier war. Breaker. I asked you what was the last 2 days the situation here in Damascus.
Well, the events here were explosive, literally explosive, because the terrorist in Eastern Ghouta has been shelling Damascus with missiles and with mortars, and it is dropping everywhere. It is dropping in Babtouma, in Bab Shar'i, in Jaramana, Assa, Malki just today in the what they call it, the Jahaz garden. It has killed like 9 people today, and it's continuing. But the good news is that the Syrian government is progressing, and today 60% of Eastern Ghouta 60% of Eastern Ghouta is under the control of the Syrian army, which 2 weeks ago was very, very less. So this is a good because the Syrian army is progressing, and I think in maybe 2 weeks, hopefully, or a month, Eastern Ghouta will be completely liberated. And when Eastern Ghouta I hope so, at least.
Yes, I hope the same.
Yeah, because when Eastern Ghouta gets completely liberated, then Damascus will be free from missiles, and it will be safe again from all these missiles that are falling and suicide bombing and all these terrorists. Because the last remaining resort for the terrorist is in Eastern Ghouta.
Okay, also ihr habt ja heute schon mal meinen Post gesehen. Es wurde hier jetzt seit den letzten Tagen ganz verstärkt auf unsere Stadtteile bombardiert aus Ghouta. Das war eben halt Bab Shar'i, Bab Touma, Jaramana und die anderen, die Drake eben gerade auch schon genannt hat. Heute sind alleine 9 Zivilisten bei den Bombardements der Terroristen aus Ghouta gestorben. Traker, you have friends? They was died by
these or? Yeah, I have a relative of my friend. His name is Faris Abreyes. He died.
What's the name?
Faris Abreyes. He died.
He, how old?
In the 20s, early 20s. Like, I think 22. Yeah, it's because of this missile. That is the problem here in Damascus. Like, you walk in the street and you don't know when a missile might just fall on your head. So you're continuously paranoid whenever you want to walk in the street or go anywhere, because you might not know when your life might be in danger. So that's why liberating Eastern Ghouta is a very important thing the Syrian army should achieve. Because when, like I said, it gets liberated, we won't have this problem anymore. Damascus will be completely free from Islamic extremist terrorism.
Ja, also er meint ja eben halt, dass das Problem ist eben halt Ghouta, und wenn Ghouta befreit ist von der Armee, dann ist hier in Damaskus auch endlich wieder Ruhe. Ich habe es ja schon ein paar Mal gepostet, auch bei mir im Hotel Mustafa Ali. Ich wohne ja direkt in Bab Shar'i. Das ist eben halt gerade mal 2 Minuten rüber.
We're drinking wine and everything is fine. We don't care whatever happens. We're going to win. The Syrian people are strong and we will stay strong. And our penis is long. And our penis brings happiness to the world.
And these? We can do here in Damascus by open-minded people, not in Ghouta. Ghouta or Idlib, you can drink not wine. You cannot sit outside and do bullshit what we do every day.
I speak to a lot of people living in the West, in Europe or America. They think that Syria is like an Islamic country where alcohol is not allowed, all the women must wear hijab. They don't know that Syria is a secular country, and this is a very good thing and an important thing everybody should know about, because Syria is a very multi-religious and ethnic country. You have the Sunnis, you have the Shiites, you have the Christian Orthodox and Catholics, you have the Alawis, you have the Druze, you have the other ethnicities like the Kurds, you have the Armenians. So it is very important to have a secular country, a secular law, so that all these people will be treated equally. But what these terrorists want is to implement a Sharia law on Syria. And this is something all the Syrians are against, because we want to live peacefully. Like you can see, the beauty about Syria is that, like you can see behind me, there is a mosque and there is a church near it, and there is a bar and there is a nightclub. And the government is telling you, you have the freedom to do whatever you want. You want to be a religious person, you can go to the mosque. You want to be a religious Christian, here's the church. You want to be an alcoholic like me and Marcos over here, you can go to the bar or to the club. You have the freedom to practice whatever lifestyle you want. And that is very important, but not everyone knows this. People think Syria is a country like Saudi Arabia.
This is what I tell you.
Yeah, where like all the women wear shadow costumes, and like all the men have pubic hair on their beards and all that kind of stuff. They don't know that in Syria we have a lot of sexy men with pink nipples like me.
He is crazy.
Cheers, everybody.
Yeah, genau. She is.
And welcome, Marcos, to Damascus, to all the people that are saying that you are not in Damascus.
Yes.
And it's a green screen behind you. Here is Marcos in Damascus with Treyka in Damascus City.
And you are a fake.
Yeah, I'm a fake too. My boobs are fake, but not me. Yeah. And this is Damascus, you can see.
You are not a typical Syrian, yes?
No, I'm not. I'm one of the sexiest and the onlyest. If that's even a word.
Also das ist das, was ich euch ja auch schon zigmal gesagt habe. Was Treyka gerade gesagt hat, ist, Syrien ist ein säkularer Staat. Hier kann jeder tun und lassen, was er will und glauben, woran er will, wenn er glauben will oder auch nicht glauben kann.
Exactly.
Also er kann tun und lassen, was er will. Wenn die Rebellen, die sogenannten moderaten Rebellen, die unterstützt werden vom Westen, die Oberhand hier gewonnen hätten, also Rota, Idlib, die gewonnen hätten, dann wäre damit nämlich vorbei gewesen. Dann hätten wir diese Säkularität und die Freiheiten hier in Syrien nicht mehr. Und das ist das Problem. Euch erzählen sie im Westen eben halt völligen Mist. Bringt mich völlig aus dem Konzept.
He's rapping in German.
Okay, ich habe jetzt gerappt. Okay, ich habe es jetzt gelernt. Demnächst, also im nächsten Post werde ich dann auf Arabisch rappen oder sowas. Mm. Also okay, wir werden heute noch ein bisschen weitermachen und noch ein bisschen weiter quatschen. Ich sage erstmal tschüss, Treyka, we'll make stop here.
What? Yeah, why not?
Okay.
Thank you all for watching, and stay safe and stay happy, because life is short, just like Marcos' penis.
Fuck you. Bye.